Hello friends, this is Neha Antal, assistant professor from IMS Ghaziabad University Courses Campus. Today I am here to discuss a topic on gram staining. What is gram staining? A gram staining is a technique to color bacteria because mostly bacteria do not retain color or we can't see easily through our microscope. Now we will continue. What is gram staining? Gram staining. There is a procedure which was introduced by a Danish bacteriologist Hans Christian Gram. After his name, this technique is, name is given. He given this technique is 1880. On this reaction or this staining, we can classify bacteria into two types, that is gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. Gram positive and gram negative bacteria, the differences, or we can say we can classify into these two types because of their difference in their cell wall structure. As we all know, gram positive bacteria has a low lipid content and gram negative bacteria is having high lipid content. Okay, basic requirement, what are the reagents or requirements we use to stain bacteria? So we here use four types of reagents. First is crystal violet, which we use as a primary stain. Then next comes to gram iodine, which is used as a mordant or a fixative. Basically, primary stain gives a color to all bacterial cells, and second one is gram iodine, which the crystal violet, which we have given that color, it works as a fixative agent. It fixes the crystal violet color to the cell membrane. Then we use acetone 95%, or we can use here ethyl alcohol as a decolorizer. Those bacterial cells which does not take crystal violet iodine or which does not makes a grams iodine, a crystal violet iodine complex, they retain the color. And after retaining the color, we use safranin as a counter stain. Those bacteria which does not take or retain color, they take up this counter stain, that is safranin color, or appear red in color. We can use dilute carbolfixin instead of safranin also. Now, what is the principle as I have discussed? Procedure. Crystal violet, there is time flow chart goes on. As we have discussed, we use four types of reagent. Firstly, when we use a stain or this reagent to stain bacterial culture, firstly we have to prepare a smear, a bacterial smear, which is a white in which bacterial cells are present, and that is a thin white or opaque colony or a circular area present on the slide. First we use crystal violet, that is used for either for 30 to 60 seconds. After 60 seconds we have to wash the slides. Then we put iodine for 1 minute. In this meantime the crystal violet iodine complex is formed. After 60 seconds, we wash it again. Then after washing, we add acetone or ethyl alcohol drop by drop so that extra color comes out from the bacterial cell, or we can say that those gram negative bacteria where lipid content is high, their hydrolysis occur and pore is created. That pore lose their color, and that color wash out from the smear. Then after that we use safranin or dilute carbolfixin, that is for 1 minute or a 30 second. Again we have to wash the slide again, and then we allow to dry the slide under air dry. After air drying the slide, we use oil immersion to study the slide under the microscope. Note that microscope, if you are using that slide or studying that slide with oil immersion, then you have to use 100x magnification power. Then result. When you see the result, when you see this light under microscope, there are two types of colony you will see. That one is gram positive, one is pink colored and one is purple colored. If you see purple colored bacteria, it means that bacteria is gram positive bacteria. If you see pink colored colonies under the microscope, that colony refers to gram negative bacteria. Now we can differentiate on the basis of a shape also. If the shape is spherical shape, that is cocci bacteria. If the shape is round, that is bacilli shape. If the cocci is shaped are present in clusters, then it is a staphylococci bacteria. If that arrangement is in chain, that is a streptococci bacteria. Here is the procedure. First, you will prepare a smear, then you put crystal violet. After adding crystal violet, you have to wash the slide. Then you have to add iodine, which is used as a mordant or a fixative agent. Then after 60 seconds, you will wash this chemical. And after this, you will wash the slide with alcohol, which will act as a decolorizing agent. And after 30 seconds, you will again stain this slide with a countless stain, that is safranin. Now that makes the slide differentiable into two parts, that is purple colored and the pink colored. Here there are some pics, that is gram positive cocaine clusters, this is gram positive cocaine chains, that is gram negative cocaine and clusters again or in chains, that is gram negative bacilli, that is rose shaped bacteria, this is gram positive bacilli, that is rose shape. There are some examples like gram positive cocaine clusters, staphylococcus species, negative cocaine chains, streptococci species, gram negative cocci, Neisseria species, gram negative bacilli, E. coli, which is very common. Next one is Klebsiella, gram positive as Clostridium species, Corynebacterium, and Bacillus anthracis. Thank you.